groundbreaking ceremony. So let's put Mario at center, and then we'll bring the governor up. He'll be the left winger. He'll be the power forward on the left side of Mario, right? Well, there are no right wingers here, right? We're all Democrats. And have we'll put Mr. Honorado on the right side. So he'll be the sniper on the right wing, right, Dan?
Seriously, was it? How strong a possibility do you think it was that this day would never come here?
No, it wasn't a possibility. I mean, we had to do a few things to put pressure on the city and the state. But our goal was to remain here in Pittsburgh all the way. Those trips to Kansas City and Vegas and other cities was just to go and have a nice dinner and come back.
The governor and the mayor talked extensively about the fan influence on this whole process. Are you aware of how much they were reaching them along the way?
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, from our meetings with the governor and the mayor and Dan, you know, they let us know that we had a lot of support from our fans, which was the key for us. The fans showed that they wanted to keep this team here in Pittsburgh forever, and that's one of the reasons that we're standing here today is because of our fans and great support that we've had throughout the years.
Did you question whether this day would happen to you? Did you know?
Yeah, a few times. You know, like they said earlier, there were a lot of ups and downs throughout the negotiations. I got frustrated a few times, but at the end of the day, I wanted this team to stay here. I've been with this franchise since 84, and it would have been a shame to see this franchise go somewhere else. So the Penguins belong in Pittsburgh, and that's where we are tonight.
You arrived here in 84. I mean, it wasn't a great hockey city that you knew of. What, did you ever think it would get to the point where there was this much passion for those fans to be able to steer this?
Yeah, that was my goal. When I came in 84, I gave myself 5 years to build a great team, and it took a little longer, but... you know, I knew from the start this was a good hockey city my first couple years in the league, and certainly it took a while to build it up to where it is today, but we're all very proud of what we have accomplished here with the team that we have and the support that we have in this region.
Any concern over the fact of Barnes Casino deal, and if that doesn't go through, if that could affect this construction at all with the money not coming in?
No, I don't think so. I think that Mr. Bloom said already that if he gets approved today, he's going to honor the commitment of Mr. Barnes. So from that point of view, I think everything should be fine.
Have you met Mr. Bloom?
I've met with him a couple years ago, yes.
You know, you've been through a lot. Bankruptcy, mm-hmm. the thrill of Stanley Cup, and now ownership and all of this that you went through to get this new arena. Are you ready to hand off the ownership reins and sit back and chill out and enjoy?
No, not for a while. It's, you know, Ron Burkle and I and the entire ownership group is very happy the way the business has been over the last couple of years. We certainly had a lot of fun this past year getting to the Stanley Cup Finals, and as long as the ownership group is having fun with it and putting a good product on the ice, I'll be here for a while.
Along those lines, Mary, have you talked to Ron Burkle recently about the casino issues and how the funding might come in, and is he at all concerned about it or no?
No, it's not an issue for us. I mean, that's a separate issue. And as I said, whoever gets the license will have to stay with the commitment that was made by Mr. Burkle.
How